We have with us a very dynamic personality, Mr. Nilesh Gupta sir, head of pre-foundation division, Carrer Point Kota.
Hi sir.
Hi.
So sir, today our topic is stress management. So our first question is,
sir, to start your day on a positive note, what will you do?
Generally, I play some sort of games, my sports. So when I play those sports, I feel very motivated, very energetic.
You play every day?
Almost every day.
So nice of you, sir.
Sir, what is your opinion regarding stress management? How much it is effective in, you know, in creating a good environment among your employees?
The stress management is very important because any position, wherever you are working, sometimes there are professional issues or there are personal issues, and sometimes one becomes very stressful. And if you are very stressful, and at those times, if a difficult situation comes, so your response to that situation may not be that wise as it should be, and it can further escalate the situation. So this stress management is a very important thing. And when you are, it is very important to realize that when you are under tremendous stress, you should withdraw yourself from that particular position. You should not handle that role for a time being. Otherwise, it will further escalate the problem.
Sir, what are your views regarding self-hypnosis and guided meditation?
Self-hypnosis?
Yes, sir.
I have never heard about it. Motivation, guided meditation?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I take it as a meditation only. I don't know what is guided meditation. Meditation? I think meditation or hypnosis, whatever I understand, is it's more about the self-realization. Yeah. It's a time when you interact with yourself. What I'm doing, why I'm doing. And it's a time to cool down. So this is something which is very important, and that can come into the various forms.
Yes, so self-hypnosis is just seeing that, as you have said, that it is a self-assessment.
It's a self-assessment. So that can come from any form. You know, somebody who is a music lover, when he's listening to music, there could be a lot of calmness which can come. So for example, I love cycling. So if I cycle that one particular day, so I become very calm. All my stress goes out if I cycle for 5 to 6 kilometers. So for me, cycling is a meditation.
Yes, and it's good for health too.
It's good for health.
According to you, to do what you love is meditation. To do what you love is meditation.
Yeah, if you're enjoying doing something, and if it's taking, if it's you are able to utilize that in a more effective way in your personal life.
Sir, what measures you have taken to provide a very good environment to your employees and creating a healthy environment and working environment?
I think the first thing is sharing the knowledge, keeping a clear-cut communication so no situation of conflict arises. Okay. And the third thing, in case of a conflicts between the employees, so we look for a peaceful solution. Let's hear that everybody. Sometimes it may happen that employee is under stress and he may get very vocal during the conversation. So what we do is we patiently listen, and once the things get settled down, we tell him this is how we should handle the situation. So there are a lot of case studies, there are a lot of stories which are told to the employees how to handle that particular situation that we do. And apart from this, we do it. Regular outings and all those things, games and activities. We have an indoor sports room also. So we motivate our employees to go and play for half an hour, 15 minutes, table tennis, badminton, tennis, carry. So this is also a different routine for them from their routine activities.
Yeah. Sir, how do you prioritize and utilize your effective time management skills in response of your employees? In regarding your employees?
Say again.
Sir, how do you prioritize and utilize your effective time management skills in respect of your employees?
So, in respect of employees?
Yes, sir.
I think engaging them into the productive task is a very important thing. We need to engage them in the productive task. And it's very important if you can keep recording the things, what you are doing, so you don't forget it. What happens is, generally, sometimes it happens, even after spending 8 to 9 hours in the organization, you tend to forget a lot many things. So what, in terms of employee time management, what I always ask them to do is that whenever they come for a meeting, they should come with a diary and pen, and they should note down and try to have the communication as important communication in the form of a mail, so they don't forget the things.
Yes, and that's time could also be saved.
Time could also be saved. So they should not be no. Time is wasted when there's a lot of repetition. So we avoid repetitions.
And sir, you know, sometimes happen that when we are working, there's something in our head going on, so that we are. So does the stress of your private life affect your professional life?
Always.
Sometimes. Always.
It affects. So it's very important to have a conscious feeling that I need to insulate myself from my personal life. And at the same time, when there's a professional stress, it affects your personal life.
Yes, sir.
So, what we should do to avoid that?
What we should do? I think it's maintaining a balance, work-life balance. So, the priority should go to the both the hands equally. Your professional life is as important as your personal life. You can't say your personal life is more important, you can't say your professional life is important, because both are complementary to each other.
Yes, sir.
If you do well in the professional life, then only your personal life will grow, and if you do not do well in the personal life, your professional life will also suffer.
Okay, sir. And sir, I would like to ask you that, do you like you to give rewards or praises to your employees when they fulfill your satisfaction?
Yes, there are a lot of ways by which we do it, in terms of performance link incentive, in terms of Diwali bonuses, in terms of a small token of appreciation. We keep doing it.
Okay, and do you think that is it enough to make your employee's mindset stress free? Or you should do something else?
There are measures which you are taking, but yeah, there are a lot of additional things which you can take care of. And sometimes it happens that, especially lower level employees, there are reasons of stress are very different from the high level of employees. So people get stuck up or people get stressed up because of very small things. And sometimes if you can speak to them 2 minutes with a care, that can also de-stress them. Sometimes if you can give them a helping hand, that can also de-stress them. Sometimes they need counseling. And sometimes they are going through stress because of their internal conflicts. Employee versus employee conflict. So if you can hear them out, that also de-stresses them. So we do a lot, we keep doing a lot of measures, yes, but there's a tremendous scope. There's a further we can do.
Yes, your points are really effective ones.
And so this is our last question. What is your definition of success? Is stress management is a key to success or liability barrier?
I think it's very important. To get important, to move higher into the organization, it's what we call it emotional quotient. It's always more important than intelligence quotient. And emotional quotient is all about managing lot many things, lot many priorities on go, at the same time not losing the temper.
Sir, I would like to end with my question that helping a little can make your world better, make you feel better. Does that help you feel better? Have you done that? Have you experienced the power of such in your whole life?
Having a?
Helping can make you feel.
That's really wonderful when you help somebody, whether it's a student, whether it's an employee, or whether it's anybody, any stranger. If you give it a helping hand, you always feel better. And I've seen, even when it comes to the students or the parents, sometimes they come with the problems. And if you go out of the way to help them, even dropping to somebody, even somebody's got minor accident, if you just put a bandage on it, it really feels great about it. Yeah. And sometimes helping them with the financial matters. So these all things, small things, have a very cascading effect. So it's really good.
Thank you so much, sir, that you took out your auspicious time for this. So this is for all today. Thank you all.